Today, I'm going to be talking about a very interesting new project and ICO that started on June 4th. It's called Open Source University, or OS University for short. They are setting out to solve a number of problems that exist in higher education and in professional development. They want to revamp some of the existing models, particularly in ways that could be useful not only to the learners, but also to employees at companies and to academia. And if OS University is successful in what they're trying to accomplish, it would be a big, big deal. So let's start with the problem. The main problem that OS University is looking to solve, sort of the overarching problem that everything within their project relates to, is the gap between business needs and employee education. And we've often heard about this conversation that takes place, which is that on the one hand, many jobs require a college degree, differing levels of college degree. But at the same time, a lot of what is actually required for the job is really learned on the job, and that the college degree maybe presents a framework for learning the type of thinking, for example, that would be useful to someone working in some of these jobs. So let's break down the pieces of that problem as OS University sees them. Number one, there's a sea of online educational and developmental content spread around the internet, right? And access to it is pretty unorganized. It can be difficult finding the exact online course you're looking for. The same course might be offered in two different places, maybe for different prices, or the access might be fragmented and certainly often very inefficient. Another issue is that MOOCs, the massive open online courses, are plentiful and they're getting more and more popular, but there are some pretty serious credibility and accreditation issues with some of these. A lot of the time you don't really know what you're getting or how good it is. There are lots of issues with fake diplomas, fake certifications, fake skill set claims or promises about the opportunities you'll have when you graduate. And as far as the universities and training services that are credible and do have something valuable to offer, many, if not most of them, are up to speed with current technology and ways to reach people online. And many of these organizations tend to not respond quickly enough to the needs of the job market. And this is a huge, huge issue. There's a report by the BBC that predicts that the core employment skills of 35% of jobs are going to change significantly between 2015 and 2020, largely due to automation, which is something I talk about all the time, and a lot of educational institutions are just not keeping up with those changes. So what does OS University want to do? For starters, they want to create a platform using blockchain and smart contracts that will offer a global, searchable catalog of courses, and it will give users access to online programs from a very broad range of fields, and it'll bring all or a great deal of what online education has to offer to one place, one platform, where people who want to take classes can find exactly what they need with ease. And under the same sort of umbrella of organizing online courses and the way that they're delivered and consumed, OS University wants to create a new model of curating, right? Curating, customizing, and also combining programs that can yield particular and better outcomes for learners. So imagine you're trying to learn a certain skill or become better at a certain job. What OS University wants to provide you with is a combination of courses and versions of those courses that will best help you accomplish those goals and sort of line you up with providers that have earned their reputations. And the idea is that the conventional diploma or degree paradigm could, in a sense, be bypassed, because with the platform, you'd be able to create your own curriculum from an eclectic mix of providers based on what you're trying to accomplish in terms of work and education. This can bring down the price for the learner. It could result in better educational outcomes in some situations. And if the project comes to fruition in the way in which it's intended, it could be absolutely massive. The other thing that the OS University platform would offer users is sort of like a digital resume on the blockchain. It's like a wallet for your credentials, which would include your educational background, your work experience, your skills, track record at your jobs, other qualifications, all of which can be verified and would be stored on the blockchain. And the reason this is important is because, as I've talked about on my program before, employers sometimes spend money, a lot of money in some cases, trying to verify the credentials of a prospective employee or partner. And because applicants can sometimes present false claims on their resumes, we've covered some of those stories, it's really important to improve the trustworthiness of resumes by verifying information on the blockchain using what are called competence passports. And OS University wants to do this all within a tokenized ecosystem. Businesses would interact with course providers through the marketplace, and OS University says that this would bring down learning and development costs for businesses. The way the platform will work is with a token called EDU. It's built on the ERC-20 standard. It powers the entire OS University platform. Course providers will be paid by learners and employers in EDU tokens. Learners will be awarded EDU tokens by accomplishing milestones and challenges. And there would be no fees for EDU transactions on the platform. OS University only collects fees when non-EDU crypto or fiat are used as a payment method for platform purchases as a transaction fee. That's how OS University will make money after the ICO, but EDU token transactions have a 0% platform commission. As far as the competence passport I mentioned, which is basically like your resume on the blockchain, a credential only gets added to the passport when it's unlocked by two keys, one that the user has, one that the providing institution has. So you can't just put on your resume, I have a degree from X university. You have to do it, and X university has to provide sort of the other half of that key to unlock that university, to unlock that credential on your resume. The team is interesting. The project lead is Ristjen Daskalov, co-founder of the Center for Open Science at the Technical University of Sofia. Their tech lead is Jordan Jambazov, senior software developer, 10 years of experience, open source software advocate. They have a blockchain developer as well, Dobromir Kovachev. And there's a pretty good mix of people from tech and education. And my big thing in looking at the team is, okay, ICO, tech, you need tech people, you need blockchain people. But if you're doing something in education, you actually need people from the education field, and it's important that they have that. Some current official partners, there's the Brain Workshop Institute, it's a European professional networking organization. Job Tiger is a European professional development service. They're also working with Access MBA and Cobden Partners. The token distribution, well, the pre-sale already ended successfully on December 31 of last year. They're currently in the middle of the main token sale that started June 4th. The main sale token price started at 1050 EDU per ETH, and it's going to work its way to 750 EDU per ETH over the course of the sale, which is 4 weeks ending on July 1st. There are 48 million EDU total. Just under 35 million are available to the public. There's a hard cap of 34,000 Ethereum. 3.84 million EDU go to the team and advisors, and just under a million are allocated to the bounty program. The budget, 50% product development, 20% business development, 15% marketing, 10% regulation and taxes, and then 5% total for legal and administrative fees and a contingency. So, like many of the projects I review, buy-in is going to be a crucial component of OS University's success. It's great to have a large catalog of providers. That is sort of a necessity for the project, but you need buy-in. You need educational institutions to sign on to the endeavor, and you also need individuals to sign on. And this is an industry that needs to be shaken up. There's tons of problems with the online higher education system in the US. Big picture around the world, there are all sorts of different issues in higher ed, which I talk about. And there are definitely less admirable things that ICOs could be setting out to solve than problems within education. So I think it's a worthy endeavor. It is very ambitious, and buy-in is going to be the determining factor. So check out their website, check out the white paper. I've put links underneath the video. They're also on social media. They have a YouTube channel and their own subreddit. Nothing that I say should be misconstrued as investment advice. I am making no predictions as to the value of any particular token or cryptocurrency. I'm merely talking about what the project wants to do and their plan for doing it, and everybody should do their own research.